गुड मॉर्निंग गर्ल्स, आई एम डॉक्टर किरण देसवाल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इंग्लिश, BGD गवर्नमेंट गर्ल्स कॉलेज शाहपुरा। टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर स्टोरी द रिफ्यूजीज, कंपोज्ड बाय पर्ल एस बक। वी लेफ्ट आवर स्टोरी ऑन पेज नंबर 35 इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो विच आई हैव शेयर्ड ऑन आवर व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप एंड यूट्यूब लिंक। सो before starting the story, let me sum up in brief what we read in previous videos. The refugees is a story about people who were displaced from their village due to flood, and they are hungry, they are hopeless, and they are tired. They are walking. Now they have reached in the capital, they have their belongings with them. So the writer is talking about a particular group which has particular speciality regarding clothing, dressing sense and belonging which they have. So now the focus is on the old man, who is the main character of this story. The old man is too old to walk anymore. He is too tired to walk anymore. So he stops at a place, and a passerby came there, and the vendor is selling noodles. He is hungry, so the passerby, out of pity, gives him some money. Let us see what happens next. So here we have the climax of our story. Every story has three parts: beginning, its middle, where the story builds up, and its end, the climax, which we say. So today we will see the climax. I swear I can give no more this day if I am to feed my own even nothing but noodles. But here is this old man. A passerby gives money to the old man out of pity. He says that I cannot give more. After giving this money to you, I have to eat only noodles. But he don't care. He says that tomorrow I will earn again. But you are tired, you are old, you don't have any source to earning money, to earn money. Well, I will give him the bit of silver I earn today against tomorrow, and trust to tomorrow again. If he's very hopeful, we can see that the passerby is very hopeful. If my own old father, he takes the old man as his old father, had been alive, I would have given it to him. So supposing him his old father, he gives money to the old man. He fumbled and brought out of his ragged girdle a bit of a silver coin, and after a moment's hesitation, he hesitates. Why? Because it is the money which he earned by hard work, of whole day's hard work. And he mutters, he added to it a copper penny. He thinks that this is not enough, so he adds a copper penny also. Their old father, he said with a sort of bitter heartiness. Here we have oxymoron. Two different adjectives are put together by the writer. Bitter heartiness means he is giving the money out of pity, but there is a bitterness in his heart that this is the money which I have earned by doing hard work, and I am letting this go. But he is helpless because he has to help the old man. Let me see you eat noodles. He gave him the money so that the old man can have some food. The old man lifted his head slowly. When he saw the silver, he would not put out his hand because he was not greedy. He was a man of self-respect. He said, sir, I didn't beg of you. Sir, we have good land and we have never been starving like this before. The old man replied that, sir, I didn't beg of you. Why are you giving me money? I didn't ask for money from you. Sir, we have good land and we have never been starving like this. This time the situations are out of control. That's why we are starving, but we have good land and the land is sufficient to feed us. Having such good land, but this year, what happened this year? The calamity broke. The calamity fell down. But this year, the river rose and men starved even on good land at such times. Because the situation was out of control, the whole land drowned in flood. Sir, we have no seed left. Everything went into water. Even we have eaten our seed. They were helpless due to the scarcity of food. They eaten the seeds. I told them, we cannot eat the seed. He is an old man. He is experienced. He suggested his people not to eat the seed, but they were young and hungry and they ate it. So they were helpless. They had to satisfy their hunger by eating seeds. So the passerby said, take it, said the man, take the money. And he dropped the money into the old man's smoked apron. He dropped the money on his dress and went on his way sighing. The vendor prepared his bowl of noodles and called out. The vendor was selling noodles there. He prepared his bowl of noodles and called out. He asked the old man, how many will you eat, old man? Then was the old man stirred. He felt eagerly in his apron, and when he saw the two coins there, he felt that there were two coins in his apron. The one copper and the other silver he had. One small bowl is enough. The vendor asked, how much bowl will you take? How many bowls will you take? So he said that one small will be enough. Can you eat only one small bowl then? Asked the vendor, astonished. The vendor is astonished that he has, the old man has a silver coin and a copper one too. But why he just ordering half bowl? It is not for me, the old man answered. He ordered just one small bowl. And he was saying that this is not for me. The vendor stared astonished, but being a simple man, he said no more, but prepared the bowl. He was astonished. Not for him, then for whom? The bowl is ordered. And when it was finished, he called out, here it is. And he waited to see who would eat it. He was curious to know for whom the order is made. Then the old man rose with a great effort and took the bowl between his shaking hands and he went to the other basket. There, while the vendor watched, the old man pulled aside the quilt. We know that the old man also has a burden of two baskets. In one basket, he has quilt and cauldron. In other one, he just have the quilt. So the old man pulled aside the quilt until one could see the shrunken face of a small boy lying with his eyes fast closed. A small child was lying there. His eyes were closed. One would have said the child was dead, except that when the old man lifted his head so his mouth could touch the edge of the little ball, he began to swallow feebly. The child was very weak, so he began to swallow noodles feebly. Until the hot mixture was finished, the old man kept murmuring to him, there my heart, there my child. So the vendor guessed that it might be his grandson. So he asked, your grandson, old man, is this small child? Is your grandson? Yes, replied the old man. The son of my only son. This small child is the son of my only son. Both my son and his wife were drowned as they worked on our land when the dikes broke. His son and his daughter-in-law were working on the fields, but suddenly the dikes broke and they drowned. He covered the child, their little child was left. The old man is having him with him. He covered the child tenderly and then, squatting on his haunches, he ran his tongue carefully around the little ball and removed the last trace of food then. And though he had been fed, he handed the bowl back to the vendor. "But you have the silver bit. You can order another one bowl for you also." "That is foreseen," cried the ragged vendor, yet more astonished. The vendor is surprised why the old man is not ordering anything for himself. When he saw the old man ordered no more, the old man shook his head and replied, "That is for seed," he replied. "As soon as I saw it, I knew I would buy seed with it, because the people have left nothing for seeds. They ate up all the seed, and with what shall the land be sown again?" So it is a concerned question. I'm concerned about that when the water will be less, so how will be the land sown again? "If I were not so poor myself," the vendor is also poor, so he replied that, "If I were not so poor myself, I might even have given you a ball. But to give something to a man who has a bit of silver," he shook his head puzzled. "I cannot give a ball of noodles free of cost to a man who has a silver coin." "I do not ask you, brother. The old man is very cool. He's a man of self-respect. He's a man of having great patience." "I do not ask you, brother," said the old man. He replied very gently that, "I didn't ask for the noodles from you. Well, I know you cannot understand, but if you had land, you would know it must be put to seed again. I'm a farmer. I have land. So only I can know the importance of seeds. But if you had land, you would know it must be put to seed again, or there will be starvation yet another year. If we do not put seeds in the land, again we will face the starvation. The best I can do for this grandson of mine is to buy a little seed for the land. Yes, even though I die and others plant it, the land must be put to seed. It's my determination." He is very determined that the land should be put to seed. "Doesn't matter if I die, someone other will show that." He took up his load again, his all legs trembling, and staring his eyes down the long straight street he staggered on. He started walking again. So he's very determined, he's very hardworking, he's very hopeful. Thanks for watching.